どうやら案内してもらう必要はねえみてえだぜ。
つまり友達は大事ってことだろ。
In the first episode of Boruto, we can see that the hidden leaf is destroyed. Most likely Ichigi or Kawaki was the one who did it, and this is really huge thing. Elite shinobi forces still exist in Boruto. In the aftermath of the 4th Shinobi World War, all 5 great nations and the Land of Iron had suffered crippling losses of personnel, with Komugakure being nearly completely destroyed by the Ten Tails-tailed Beast Ball, which had wiped out the Elite headquarters, which was located near the village. To recover from these losses, the Elite Shinobi forces transitioned into the Shinobi Union, which sped the recovery efforts up, as well as opened the door for smaller Shinobi villages, such as Amegakure or Kusagakure, to join as equal members, eliminating the need of war for resources. I am pretty sure they would not just ignore the destruction of the Hidden Leaf, the strongest village among them, and realize that there is too much danger out there, and would declare war on whoever did it. And one of the most important person in that situation is Orochimaru, who has almost limitless potential, and is one of the most valuable ally of the Hidden Leaf. We have already seen that he has no desire to betray the Hidden Leaf and have any connection with Kara. And if the 5th Great Ninja World War begins, I am pretty sure that he will be on the Elite Shinobi Forces side. He can reanimate a lot of interesting ninjas, for example the Hokages, Obito, Madara, Itachi, the Akatsuki, and etc. If they work together, they can potentially rival Ichigi Otsutsuki. Also, unlike the previous war, Orochimaru now owns Hashirama's cells. With it, he can produce white jutsus and revive people without any living sacrifice. And now imagine, every villain and hero uniting together in the Great Ninja War against their common enemy. It clearly would be one of the most exciting moments in the franchise history. Many people think that if Madara was reanimated in Boruto, he would be on enemy side, since he himself was a villain for a really long time. But I disagree with that. Madara just had a different perspective of seeing things. Just like Hashirama wanted the good of the village, so did Madara. But his violent upbringing and powerful clan easily influenced his mind. At the end, even though Madara wanted peace, he sought it by enslaving humanity. Madara wanted the people to live in peace so much, he had prepared how to be resurrected. He had made plans to come back from the dead with the help of a successor in an overly complicated and difficult plan, just so he could give peace to his people. Not out of spite, for vengeance, for power, for destruction, but for the people. His troubled mind sought this by enslaving the whole world in an eternal dream. Madara, however, finally realized how faulty his plans were, and they would never be successful, because he was heading the wrong way. He came to peace with a new generation taking over, and joined the afterlife with Izuna and Hashirama. So Madara has already properly realized what his wrongs were, and what the rights are. If he were to be resurrected in Boruto, he would be much like Sasuke. Beside Madara, resurrecting Might Dai would also come in handy, since we know that only Taijutsu is effective on the Otsutsukis, and Might Dai could spam his 8th gate. He would be one of the most important ally for the allied shinobi forces in the war. And also, let's not forget Itachi Uchiha, who has arguably the most hexed Susanoo in the entire series. His Yata Mirror and Tatsuka Blade would also play an important role in the war, since Tatsuka Blade is said to be one of the strongest sling technique, and Yata Mirror can repel absolutely any attack, which of course would come in handy in every battle. I also hope that Sakumo will be finally reanimated, so that we'll be able to see his powers and abilities, which made him one of the most famous ninja in history of Naruto. However, I am not so sure which side would pure evil type villains like Kakuzo, Hidan, Deidara would take in this battle, but I believe they would also join their fellow ninjas in that war. As you can see, Orochimaru really owns a trump card in the face of Eda Tensei. It is one of my favorite techniques, and I really hope we'll see it again in Boruto. I don't think that allied shinobi forces are strong enough to rival the Otsutsukis by themselves, but let's see how strong the new generation of ninjas will be after the time skip. They surely have very big potential to surpass their parents. Anyway, I guess this is all for today. What do you think about this animation and 5th Great Ninja World War? Write your opinions in the comments, like this video and subscribe to this channel for more. Astrojack out. Bye.